from my perch in Mexico City, having conducted this assessment, it became clear to me that the greatest concern was the overwhelming presence of these sophisticated human smuggling organizations that existed and utilized Mexico as the final staging point to move illegal aliens into the United States. I'll just tell you operationally, what we did is, at the U.S. Embassy, I chaired a working group with one of my colleagues from the intelligence community, and we said, we got to work smarter, not harder. And basically, we put together a program to identify those smuggling organizations, those smuggling networks. We did that through good, hard investigative efforts. And it's difficult because when you're overseas, as an FBI agent, I may as well not carry my credentials and my badge because they're useless. I'm on foreign soil. I have no authority to conduct an investigation. I had to do that in liaison with my partners in country. And in Mexico, we worked very closely with the Attorney General's office, we worked with the National Police, we worked with the Mexican Intelligence Service, CISEN. In terms of our operational perspective or our tack was is to identify those smuggling organizations through good intelligence collection. The Mexicans cooperated with us. There were numerous SIAs being held in Mexican detention centers. I remember at one point in Tapachula, Mexico, which is down on the river of the Guatemalan-Mexican border, there were 700 East Africans being held in detention there, Somalians and Sudanese. The Mexicans worked with us. We collected a lot of intelligence from their documents, from their telephones, and so forth, and we were able to identify the smuggling organizations and the people that were pulling the triggers for those organizations. And we targeted those organizations. We not only targeted them in Mexico, we targeted them globally. The French, the Greece, and others worked operations with us, and we were able to shut down some of those groups.